and then probability of x belongs to A if A is an event. Event means it is belonging to F. Remember the definition of event. Event means belonging to F. That means a subset of omega. This is a subset of omega. This is a subset of omega. The subset containing all those omega, small omega, such that first term is H. First term is H. So this is discrete probability space. This is an example of discrete probability space. If the coin is perfect, we write this equals to half, this equals to half. Then half plus half equals to 1. So this will be half cube, half cube, half cube. All are half cube. But in general, because we don't know how the coin is, so we write P and Q. And then this PI, P1, P2, PN, and so on, corresponding to omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, omega n, this we call distribution of x. We say this is distribution of x. Right? And so this is distribution of x. This is just a table of column containing all these values. For each omega belonging to capital omega, we have probability of x equals to omega. All such value for omega 1, omega 2, omega n, this column is a distribution of x. It is a distribution of x. Now, why did we need the random variable to be measurable? When we define random variable, we say this must be measurable function.
Uh-huh. So we can count.
So we can define the measure function. When we studied measure space, these functions are defined only for measurable sets. So we should this is okay, integration. Anyway, so when we define the measure function, we define only for measurable sets. Now you see, you take this, 3 is from Borel sigma algebra, and x inverse 3 is HHH, this belonging to this sigma algebra F. And that's why we can define P of HHH. Since in a discrete probability space, we take F equals to P omega, so all the functions, all the x will be measurable. Nothing to check because this contain all the sets. You understand the power set or not? Power set and sigma algebra. Power set is a sigma algebra, but sigma algebra can be smaller than power set. Power set is sigma algebra means you must have phi s. If there is A, there is A complement. That's all. Power set of S means collection of all subsets of S. All subsets of S. Sigma algebra is, sigma algebra is collection of some subsets of S. We satisfy all three properties. The definition of sigma algebra was a family of subsets of S which satisfies three properties. Remember or forget already? Sigma algebra? Sigma algebra was collection of subsets such that three properties were satisfied. The three properties, the three properties are phi s belongs to sigma. If a belongs to sigma, implies a complement belongs to sigma. If there are few sets in sigma, their union will be in sigma. And what is power set of S? Power set of S is the collection of all subsets of S. This is some particular subsets of S. Sigma algebra may be smaller than power set of S. There are two sigma algebras. Very easy. Two sigma algebra. One is phi S, just contain phi S. This is the minimum or least minimum sigma algebra. Second is power set of S. This is the minimum one, phi n S, nothing else. And another is power set of S, which contains all the subsets of sigma algebra. In discrete probability space, we took the largest sigma algebra. So everything inside this, no need to check whether that function inside this or not, because everything will be inside the power set of S. When this is uncountable, the surface space is uncountable, it is derivative security too. You will study continuous time model, this will be uncountable. This will be uncountable means this F is something other than power set of omega. In that case, you have to check whether this random variable is measurable or not. As long as you are inside finite or countable set, you have nothing to check. Any function from sample space to R is random variable. But as soon as this is uncountable, we have to check whether, because this is not power set of omega, this is some sigma algebra, we have to check whether this X is measurable or not. Otherwise, you cannot define power, otherwise you cannot define probability measure. In measure space, A is sigma mu. Mu is defined only for measurable sets. So this is uncountable means this is something else, not power set of S. So you have to check whether random variables are measurable or not, because if it is not measurable, you cannot define probability of X belonging to some event. Probability of tossing a coin and first toss is F. If this is infinite, if this is infinite number of toss, you cannot define probability of X belonging to A, where A is first toss gives a head. So you don't need to check whether X is measurable or not, but if you don't remember the actual definition, when you get uncountable, you cannot proceed. So better remember what is random variable. Okay, just one thing. So now you know surface space. Now you know F is, we still are using power set of omega, the biggest one. And then we know Central space is omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, omega n. This is countable sample space. So countable number of sample points. And probability of x equals to omega 1 is p1. Probability of x equals to omega 2 is p2, and so on. And if there is an event like this, first toss gives a head, or just second toss gives a head, these are called event. Event means a subset of omega. A subset of omega. Then probability of x belongs to A is just sum over all the omega I belongs to A and take the probabilities. Probability of x belongs to A, x belongs to A means sum over all the points where first toss is ahead. Probability of HHH, HHT and so on. So, and this PI, these things are called distribution of X. This P1, P2, PN are called distribution of X. So we know probability X belongs to A is summation omega I belongs to A PI. Right? What will be probability X A to B? One, two. From here. This example. In this example, omega is HHH and all this, we have already written everything, all the values, X of HHH and all this. I need to know probability of 1 less than equals to X less than equals to 2.
6 over 8.
So which are the sample points? This actually mean probability omega belongs to omega. Such that x omega is in 1 to 2.
Oh.
Right?
Oh.
This is the full sentence. This is in English, full sentence. We write probability 1 less than equals to x less than equals to 2. Because we can understand, we are discussing about this. So, what is the values of omega? What is this set? What is this set? Just tell me the set first. Such that. What is the set? This is the sample space. This is sample points. And this is the tabulation or. We say distribution. This is the distribution. For this omega 1, x of omega 1 is 3. For x omega 2 is 2. And so on. So on. So what, when x omega is from 1 to 2?
Done.
This.
Which TH we repeat already?
Hey, how to do this? Just
which TH repeat?
We need x omega between 1 to 2. So, just take this and this.
Yes.
Why so difficult? X omega in 1 to 2. So, these are the 1. THT, HTT, TTH. These are the 2. HTH, HHT, THH. So, this is the same. Now, we need probability of all this omega such that x omega from 1 to 2. That means probability of this set. Probability of this set means we just sum over pi. We just sum over pi. Omega I belongs to a pi. So
we see we need
this is p square q plus p square q plus p square q. All are p square q. P square q plus p q square plus p q square.
So repeat the one repeat the
TTH
suppose.
TTH? Yeah.
HTH.
THT. Okay, anyway. Something here. So the thing is probability of omega belongs to omega such that x omega from 1 to 2. We write this in short, probability x from 1 to 2 is nothing but we take this tabulation or distribution. We say distribution of x and take these points, sample points. We put the sample points here and find out the probability of each. Right? So, we know probability of 1 less than equals to x less than equals to 2 if we are given this. So done. So this one we can find out. This one we can find out if we are given the sample space and the sigma algebra and the this point pi. These are the pi. If we are given, so we can find out probability of, in general, probability of A less than equals to X less than equals to B. We can find out. Here A and B are numerical values 1 and 2. So we can find out from 0 to 3 or from 2 to 5. Everything we can find out. You understand this one means probability of X inverse AB. This means what this one means? Probability of omega belongs to omega such that A less than equals to X omega less than equals to B. This means probability of omega belongs to omega such that X omega belongs to open interval AB. That means we need all those omega for which X omega belongs to AB. Same thing as we need all those omega for which X inverse probability of X inverse AB. Probability of all omega such that X omega belongs to AB means we need probability of X inverse AB. Understand or not? This one? This is the capital omega. These are omega 1, omega 2, omega n. These are omega 1, omega 2, omega n. We can find out probability of x less than equals to A greater than equals to A less than equals to B. This is same as probability of X inverse AB. And this AB is measurable shape. Okay, next day. This AB is open interval, means this is measurable set. If X inverse AB not belongs to F, we cannot define probability of this. That's why we need measurable function. Until you are in countable or finite set, no problem. Once you are in uncountable, you cannot find this. And this is the important thing. This is probability of x less than equals to small x or suppose y. You know this distribution function? Distribution function for a random variable. So if you cannot define this, if you cannot define this, then you cannot define distribution function. That's why you need x to be measurable. That's why you need x to be measurable.